यू नो ओवरसीज ए फ्री एजुकेशन प्लेटफॉर्म टू हेल्प द नीडी स्टूडेंट्स रिलेटेड टू फ्री एजुकेशन एज वेल एज टू प्रोवाइड मटीरियल टू द स्टूडेंट्स हु आर अंडर पॉवर्टी लाइन. सो जस्ट वी नीड योर हेल्प टू प्रमोट इट. वॉच ऑलवेज सब्सक्राइब द वीडियो. इट इज मल्टीटेक एजुकेशन फॉर यू. ए फ्री प्लेटफॉर्म फॉर एवरीबॉडी फॉर एजुकेशन बट मटीरियल फॉर द स्टूडेंट्स बिलो पॉवर्टी लाइन. वी हैव जस्ट स्टार्टेड. सो योर इफ यू सब्सक्राइब पुश द बेल शेयर इट. इट विल बी ए ग्रेट हेल्प टू प्रमोट अवर दिस फ्री एजुकेशन प्लेटफॉर्म. एट द मोमेंट आई एम अलोन एंड पुशिंग अप द थिंग्स एंड वी हैव सो मैनी कॉन्टेंट्स. मीन्स वॉट एवर स्टूडेंट वॉन्ट टू लर्न ही कैन फाइंड इन अवर वीडियोज लाइक पीसीबी डिजाइनिंग प्रोग्रामिंग कोडिंग एंड लाइटिंग एफेक्ट्स एलईडी एफेक्ट्स बेसिक वीडियोज फॉर बेसिक नॉलेज. सो लेट अस स्टार्ट. सो माई डियर फ्रेंड्स यू सी दिस इज 3D. दिस इज PCB which will get manufactured from the manufacturer. After we design it, this the printout we can make it if you want to make it at home. And this is my way to learn about the symbols. I note down the function and the name of the symbol. When I used to forget, I see it. So now, last time we completed schematic wiring diagram and just was going to start with the board file, and this was our circuit. According to circuit, we see our schematic wiring diagram. It should be perfect before moving to the board file, because board file will be the final to give it, so to send it for the manufacturing. After completing that, of course, some things we can rectify in the board file also. Some people, they don't make schematic, they direct jump to the board file. From the board they used to make, they have so much practice. So it is not needed. We will go one by one. Again we will come to our folder, open that schematic, full wave, rectifier. And now you see only full wave is visible. When we will open board file, save it, it will come here also. The board file will start appearing in our Multitech for you folder. Still there is only one file, full wave rectifier schematic. So we'll open it and move it, and the board I told you we will select it from the schematic drawing, not from the control panel. If you will select from the control panel, this circuit will not come in our board file. So again I'll tell you to check the grid first. That is very important. Grid should always be there. And now we'll come to board file. From here we will select to make our board file. You see my cursor? Yes, create from the schematic. Yeah. So up to here we see it before also. Now our board file is here and all the components with the wiring has come. But this wiring is temporary. We will convert this wiring into routing where your copper will run for the circuit. So now our platform is this board file. This is our PCB size, little big. Afterwards, after placing the components properly, we will reduce it. We will minimize this PCB size. So here what we will do, again one by one or all together we can bring these components here, but better one by one. So we are going to first make the grid. I told you before, the same size we have to select, 0.635 mm, and below it will remain same, but we will change it to mm. So the printout will come the exact of the same size. When you will take this file out, export it and copy paste it in your Word file, the same size will come. Sometimes what happen, they show something else but the size is different, then you have to adjust it. So to get the same size what you are making here in our Word file, the grid is a must. So now grid has come here, and we have chosen the black platform, so it will not glare in our eyes. We can choose white also, but I prefer black one. User interface, from here you see the background, you can change, you can select white also. So I will keep it as it is black. On the top, from nothing to change, from the top you just select white, your platform will become white. You see it is glaring, my components are not visible, the wiring has got dim. So user interface, and you change black. It is up to you. If you can work on that white, it's okay. So black one, you see now wiring is visible, components are visible, so workability become easy. So we will drag these one by one, these components. There are two, three ways also to select these components. From the schematic also you can select, and that component will be highlighted. Take it there, and afterwards you will see the PCB will be like this, 3D model will be like this. This is of my previous project, I made it before also, that is what I am showing you. So this type of model we need to get it, so, and it rotates also. You can see the various ways from various angles. So this is our circuit. Now first, what is the pin head, right? So first we will place, we will drag the pin head from this congested circuit diagram on our board. So I am not using transformer here, transformer will remain outside. From the transformer, 12 volt AC will come to the pin head. So now we see, you can see from here also, you can select it, but for a small circuit you can do it, but when there is a big circuit, so many components, hundreds, so then we will need to go to the schematic and select our, from our circuit, that component will be highlighted here. So one by one we can pick it up there. So different ways. Now you see, if you will select from a schematic this pin head, you select it here, it will be highlighted there in the board file. You see it has been highlighted. Tell me which one is this. This one, this is highlighted. So we will drag it first. So if you will move step by step, just click, select move button and move it inside. So this pin head will come there, and we have to keep it on the left side. Then we will see the position of it, whether to rotate or not. Select move button, click it again and take it inside. You see, it comes here. So first we will do like this. then we will check the wiring where it is crossing each other. So where there is no way, then we have to make two layer PCB. So we'll try for one layer, minimize the crossing of the wires. So just watch, one by one I will bring there. Now next is the diodes we have to bring. We will go to our schematic, see how in a schematic we have placed it. So check in that and accordingly here it is different, and our schematic design I have made it in parallel. You see D1, D2, D3, so we will drag as per this schematic. Similar way, so that if you will do like this, I select it, okay, go to board D1, D2, D3. Now you see in the board it has been highlighted, it is there, this one. So I will bring it to the board, move and drag. Now the position is here in our schematic. Forget about these wires crossing each other, this and that. Don't get confused. Just first place your components. Then we will move to one by one. Where should be positive, where should be negative. How the pin head will need to be rotated. Diode to be rotated. So first place D1. Then D2, D3, D4. In the same way in our schematic. So it makes the things easy to work with. Now this distances we can maintain afterwards, we can bring them close. Pin head is little bit far, so step by step. So first let us see and place our components. Forget about wire, where it is going, where it is going, it is getting a like red snake. You know, this net is like red's net. So don't get confused. Let it be there, wires. Just bring your components, put them as per the schematic. So just watch, my dear friends. In the same way you can rotate. Just select and right click your mouse or the laptop, right button. So it will rotate after selection, and move button you can drag it anywhere. So we need these two three things: moving, rotation, afterwards how to get rid of this jungle of the wires, make proper routing. These wires we will change for the copper routing. See the circuit, go ahead, after diodes what was there, capacitor. So it makes easy, afterwards easily you can change the things, there will be no hodgepodge. Using your brain, practice, you will perfect. This we will see, these wires, what to do afterwards. You will see. You see, this wire is going there. I am trying to minimize the crossing of the wires. So in the same way you can do it. We have to check the positive of the capacitor, positive, negative of the diode, which side is it, accordingly we will move as per our the schematic drawing. The positive is at the right, negative is the left of these diodes, so that we have to check. So we need to rotate. Same with the capacitor, where positive is going positive, so just I am bringing them close. You see, it should neither be very close nor be very far. If you will make very far, the PCB will be weak. If you will bring these components very close, there will be chances of short circuit in your PCB when you get after manufacturing. See, this is the voltage regulator. You see, this is the symbol same we selected from the library. Now on the board file, right side symbol will come. When we selected all these symbols from the library, you might have seen two symbols, left and right. Left side was for schematic, right side was for board file. So the same symbol have come, what we selected. Now resistance, LED. You see, I am trying to place the capacitor, these things similar to the schematic, but exactly you cannot do as per the schematic. As per the board condition, wiring condition, you can take little bit left, right, change little bit position according to the board symbols. So what is left only? This resistance for LED, 4.7K. This is LED. You see, the LED, one corner is flat, means that is the negative side of the LED. The circle of the LED you may be looking at is little bit cut from one side, means that side is negative. A little bit electrical knowledge is enough to proceed. So after this board file, we will move to the Gerber file, 3D model, and panelizing. If our PCB is small, we can make 6 PCB, 4 PCB in one PCB. 5 PCBs they give for $2, suppose. So if we will make 5 PCB in one board file, so we will get 5 only. If we will panelize it, because their size is 10 cm by 10 cm, we can make 4 PCB in that. So we will get 20 PCBs after panelizing, completing this board. And for the beauty also, if you want to make it at home, we will copper fill all this PCB. So step by step we are coming. Now let us be here. You see, what I did, I choose rat's net from the left side at the bottom. Okay, I clicked that, the wiring hodgepodge got minimized automatically. It is at the left side bottom, rat's net. If you will click that, so much wiring will come adjust by itself. It will not change the circuit, but it will minimize the wiring. The rat's net. Rat's net had too much use. It is at the left, at the bottom. Now again, this is the skill, practice. You see, I am minimizing crossing of the wirings. If there will be crossing, no problem. What maximum will happen? We will change, select two layers. So the layer which is crossing, it will come on the bottom or the top. So both sides we will get this routing. So now again red snap, see, I click, again it will minimize the things. You see, it gives the wires shortcut. Still we need to work on it. But the red snap has solved too much problem, too much hodgepodge, crossing. And with the help of red snap, it itself choose the nearest way to save the wiring, to save the routing, to save the copper. Now I am not satisfied, see. But even then, let us be like that. Now I have choose the route from the top and connect it. You can change the width of this copper routing. You can make little bit big. You see, it is little thick. This is thin, and when I choose the upper little bit thick width of the root, it has become thicker. I don't need it, so I will select the straight from the top and it will go straight. Where I need to turn it at right angle, I can choose from the top. So now this is the wiring we are doing, individual wiring, one by one. So I will delete this routing. I selected that symbol to remove this route. With that there is a root symbol, and now all you can select auto routing net. First come here, select the distance between the wires, the width of the root. So this is the standard 40 by 20. This is okay. Now we can go for auto routing. We will select top layer, not applicable, because we will bring all our copper routing at the bottom of the PCB. So we make not applicable, so just do nothing, select it. Now I have selected two layers. It has come in two layers now. One will come at the top, blue color, red will come at the bottom. So I will go back and select it again. I will go at the top, edit, select it, 40, 20, okay, okay. Now I will go again here, select the value, top, auto, no, not applicable. Below is the auto. Now I will continue. Let us see what will happen. It will change the route also and will come on one layer, one side. Yeah, I start. You see, now this is at the bottom. This copper layer will come. This is auto routing. No need to get one by one. And even then, if you want to do it in a good way, you can do it. Even from here you can select the route and bring it to this side, that side, wherever you want. You can play where you want, that this is not looking good, I want to little bit here and there. You can do it by selecting that route only. So now we'll save it. This is our file for printing. But rather, in printing, what we will do? We will fill it with the copper. The beauty will increase. Now we will reduce the size of our PCB. This is their standard size they have given. They have 10 centi by 10 centi. And we can make 4 PCBs in it. So why we should buy one only? In one PCB we will buy 4. So 5 PCB means 20 PCB for $2 we will get. So we will save the wastage. We will bring it. In the center just click. After pressing move button. If you move to the corner, there will be zigzag. Select it from the center. See, our PCB will be of this size. Means in their standard size of 10 centi by 10 centi, there will come 4 PCBs. That is called panelizing. So we will panelize it. In Eagle they don't show how many PCBs will come in panelize. Automatically it will select 4 PCB for the Gerber file. When we will send Gerber file, they will make 5, means we will get 20 PCB. So the size we can check from here. From the measurement, I have selected from the left. Measure it. So my dear friend, the symbols, you have to keep it in your mind. You have to remember it. You have to make practice of it. That from where you have to select measurement, from where you have to select the values, settings, smash, name, value, deleting, RATSnet, which is very important, RATSnet. We solve our problem of the wiring a lot. Make our wiring easy by itself, auto, without changing the circuit. So now this is the size we have. We'll make it straight. You see at the top, the size will come at the top. The vertical size will come in the left column. This is there about 40, 4 centi. Horizontal, vertical. At the top you will see, as the cursor will move after selecting measurement, the value will change there. So now we'll save it. And further, make it beautified. Now when you will get the PCB, in this stage, if you will make a Gerber file, it will come like this. So for text, there is a symbol. You can enter the text. You can write your company name. I will write my platform's name. Multitech Education for you or something like that. We can put on this PCB, whatever you want to write. From the text, from the left, select and write. And now you can place it here. Increase the size, or you write something else. It's okay now. You know, here it will look like the mirror. The opposite Multitech Education for you. So now we will fill it with the copper, the all the area. So it will look very beautiful when it will come to you, as well as if you want to make it at home, it will remove the copper, the desired one only. And all this copper will work as a ground also. So our ground wiring, ground roots will vanish. they will mix in the copper filling. So first select this from the polygon, this complete PCB outer, click it here. At 3 points you need to click, just here, second, third, and go to fourth. Close it and you will see it will be selected by this rectangle. Now this has come. So from polygon, left side symbol, click and make this. Now we will go to red's net. Once and a all, it will be filled with the copper. You see how nice it is looking now. It has left my multi-tech education for you, for the silk printout. And now we have to remove the ground, which are the ground wires. This is the ground, right? Negative. Wherever this is going. So again we will use red's net. So where it is ground, it will vanish. It will mix with the this ground filling. So just come on the rectangles, select frame, ground, right here, G and D, and okay. You see, the required ground is vanished. Somewhere it left before. So where you make ground, so many things, again it fill up that portion. So my dear friends, now for today, it has become very lengthy, the video. In next part, this is the properties. You can select again, check it and just make it okay. So further we will remove these things. The marks are coming, the frame you can select, the property, the copper, etc., whatever you want, but no need to change. Just select overlay. So to modify it more. So now what we will do, we will just start with the things in the next video. So in the meantime, you just make practice up to this point and we will start it from here. So see you my dear friends, bye to you.